Are you burdened with the guilt of sin? Is something you did in your past haunting you and accusing you of your unworthiness before God? The Bible says that the devil is the accuser of the brethren. Therefore, child of God, I want to share this message with you, someone under the sound of my voice. Don't give ears to any accusation that may come to you. The devil will always come to us with our mess and our mistakes just to cripple our faith and confidence in the Lord. But hear what the Lord has to say about you. Regardless of our shortcomings and our flaws, he told Isaiah in the book of Isaiah chapter 1 verses 18 to prophesy to the people of Israel that they should come and let us reason together. So he said, "Come now, let us settle the matter, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are as red as crimson, they shall be like wool. The Lord does not delight in the sins of men." So the Bible says in Romans chapter 3 verses 23, the Bible says that for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, but the gift of life is through Christ Jesus. This is because sin is a weight and a burden to all who do it. The whole human race, by reason of Adam's sins and our personal sin, are liable for the damage that sin causes in the life of humanity. So this is why it pleased God that he would redeem us by the precious blood of his Son. Our Lord Jesus Christ, who bled and died on the cross of Calvary to pay for the sins of you and I, and after he did this, there's forgiveness in him for our sins and to everyone who believes in his name. So this is why the Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 5 verses 9 to 10, that since therefore we have now been justified by his blood, much more shall we be saved by him from the wrath of God. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by his life. Beloved, I want you to know that whenever any thought of guilt and unworthiness comes to your mind, rebuke that thought and declare to yourself that you are free from sin because of the work of Christ on the cross. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 21, that God made Christ who knew no sin to become sin for us, so that we can become the righteousness of God through Christ. You have been reconciled with God through the work of Christ, beloved. You are no longer an enemy of God. Whatever you deserved to be punished with because of your sin is what God allowed Jesus to go through on the cross. And since God is not unjust to punish you for what he has already punished someone on your behalf for, he will not throw you out. He has always stretched his hand so mightily to embrace you and help you overcome the turmoil of life and the temptations that happen to you. So don't be ashamed. For he gives power to the faint, and to those that have no strength, he gives strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. The Bible talks about the story of a woman who was brought to Jesus with the claim that she was caught in adultery. So the Bible says that when she was brought to Jesus, Jesus wrote on the ground, asking her accusers that any one of them without sin should cast the first stone. None of them were able, because all of them had sin. So the Bible says that the beginning from the young to the elderly, all of them went one by one, without being able to cast any stone at her. When Jesus lifted his eyes, he saw none of them around, so he asked the woman, "Where are your accusers?" And the woman said, "They are nowhere to be found." Then Jesus told her, "If none of them has accused you, then I accuse you not. Go and sin no more." Whenever sin encroaches our territory, we should remember that we will not let sin have dominion over our mortal bodies. Just like Jesus told the woman that her sins have been forgiven, but rather she should go and sin no more. The same message is what I also want to share with you, that you are not a sinner. Therefore, sin no more. Let sin not have dominion over your members, because you were bought with a price, and your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, glorify God in your body, and let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works, and glorify God for that. The Bible says in Psalms 103 verses 12, that as far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. And this all happened when Jesus died on the cross. And this was what the Apostle Paul said in the book of Colossians chapter 2 verses 13 to 15. It says, "When you were dead in your sins and in the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made you alive with Christ. He forgave us all our sins, having canceled the charge of our legal indebtedness, which stood against us and condemned us. He has taken it away, nailing it to the cross. And having disarmed the powers and authorities, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them by the cross. He again says that he delivered us from the domain of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Beloved, if you think about how much of God's love he has towards his children, so such that the Bible says that since then the children share in flesh and blood, he himself, Christ, likewise, also partook of the same, that through death he might render powerless him who had the power of death, that is the devil, and might deliver those who through fear of death were subject to slavery all their lives. You will be amazed, and therefore you must not let anything rob you of the package Christ has given us in his redemption. So always voice this to yourself and declare to yourself just as the word of God has declared about you. Don't give any room for the devil, who is the accuser of brethren, to have a voice in your life. Because his main aim is to always come to deceive and lure us into believing his lies, so that our hearts will be condemned and we will not have the confidence to enjoy the blessings that God has for us. He even tried it on Jesus, but he failed. And the same way Jesus had to rebuke the enemy with the word of God and refer to him to what was written, that is the same way we must learn to live by the word, so that we will be able to stand the schemes of the evil one. Let nothing stop you, beloved. You are the beloved of God. He bought you with a price that nothing on earth can be compared to. He saved you by his own life, and that tells you how much you're worth before the sight of God. You are his beloved. Yes, you. God bless you. Stay encouraged and uplifted. Shalom.